Hey, what's up, you guys? Aftershow Reacts, y'all. And today I'm going to be watching some more Angel. This is season 1, episode 8, and it is called I Will Remember You. I've been told that I should have tissues for this episode, but I've yet to buy them. So this is going to be fun. Let's just get into it. Angel, what the hell are you doing?
For 3 days, tracking her and that thingamajiggy you saw in your vision. Where's the crabby scowl? The morbid.
But he didn't really help her with the vision. Like, while I was editing the episode, it was like that vampire that she staked at the very beginning of the episode of Buffy. So, what? It.
Don't do it, Angel.
Listen to me, man. It's not worth it. It's not?
No! You can't let her get to you like this. You'll
do you guys think that he's
else.
Going
Just
to stake himself?
Time.
Why'd you let me have that? Because I needed to level my desk and the floor's uneven. You two thought.
Doyle did. You know how he always jumps to conclusions. If my ex came to town and was all stalking me in the shadows and then left, and then he didn't even say hello, I'd be
a little upset.
Buffy!
An explanation? Who do you think you are, coming to my town, following me around behind my back?
Sorry.
What is this, some new torment you cooked up just for me?
No, I didn't want a torment.
You can see me, but I can't see you. What are we playing here?
We're not. I'm not playing anything. I wrestled with this decision.
Which you made without me.
I tried to do what I thought was right. And it's complicated how this all happened, Buffy, you know? It's kind of a long story.
Your new sidekick had a vision I was in it. You came to Sunnydale?
Okay, maybe not that long.
You didn't feel that I was important enough to even tell me that you were there.
I'm trying to explain. It's because I felt you were important that I didn't tell you.
I'm a big girl now, Angel. I'm not in high school anymore. A lot has happened in my life since you left.
I know.
Yeah!
I respect that.
Oh, they'll be into this for a while. We still have time for a cappuccino and probably the director's cut of the Titanic.
I'm sorry.
So true.
What else was I supposed to do?
I don't know. I just know that when you're around, whether I see you or not, I feel you.
That's true, dude. She kind of did. Inside. She knew someone was there, but she just didn't know.
Throws me, too.
So let's just stick to the plan. We'll keep our distance until a lot of time has passed. Given enough time, we should be able to...
Forget.
Not that one! No.
Did you hear that?
Oh yeah, the Buffy and Angel show. First they talk out their differences and then they punch them out. Stick our noses where they don't belong and get them flattened. No thank you.
Oh, Cordy. She knows them well.
Are you getting anything? Cause I sure smell sewer.
Oh, throwback to when he broke up with her on a sewer. It's a bit awkward.
Tunnel number one it is. They came to see you so I could tell you face to face not to see me face to face anymore. And I know there's a fly in that logic ointment somewhere, but the next thing I knew we were being attacked by this mutant ninja demon thing and then we're on the floor on top of each other and it's just really confusing being around you.
No, I meant I felt weird from the demon's blood.
Awkward.
Buffy's little outburst and pretend it never happened.
No, it is confusing.
If we let something happen here, we'd want more. And nothing's changed.
Oh, I've missed this so much.
We'd only end up having to leave each other again.
Oh, the Angel fan in me. Help!
I was really jonesing for another heartbreaking sewer talk.
I'm sorry.
Good job. Well, that's not good. Last time, like, demon blood got on someone, it infected Buffy, that was not good. Did you not just notice that he came in from the street?
Watch it, Doyle. Don't get too close. Hey, you walked in the front door from the street. You've got an umbrella.
He knows. Don't you, Doyle?
He's alive, buddy William.
Yeah.
Alive?
Buffy and I were attacked by some kind of demon.
Unbelievable. It's a self... I forgot how good it tastes when you're alive.
Yeah, they didn't even have cookie dough fudge.
What, so we... he can't taste as a vampire?
But it's happened, it was meant to be.
From this day, you will live and die as any mortal man.
Privy to all the attendant pains and pleasures.
That which we serve is no longer that which you serve. You are released from your fealty.
That's it, I'm free.
Well, this is a very short show then. Miss Bangel.
They've got the forbidden love of all time. They've been apart for months. Now he's suddenly human. I'm sure they're down there just having tea and crackers.
You call me? I call you what?
We stay in touch. Just not.
Literally. Funny.
Oh, come on!
I better.
Right. Remove the
tablet. He's human! Do something!
Look toxic.
Come on! Come on! There we go. Okay.
Perfect.
Oh, this is actually really cute. It's like the perfect moment.
Like a minute, and already there's cookie dough fudge mint chip in the fridge.
This is all working out nicely. I'm out of a job.
Hey, not just you, you know.
Oh, please, who are you kidding? You know you're glad this happened.
Hey, I'm glad for Angel. But if that means I'm off the hook with the powers to be as well, all the better. Mind numbing vision.
What do you see?
We got trouble.
It's still alive? Well, there's another one.
It feels pretty amazing.
I'm so glad we didn't logic ourselves out of this. Angel, this is the first time I've ever really felt this way.
What way?
Just like I've always wanted to.
This is way too good to be true. I don't like it.
Like a normal girl. Falling asleep in the arms of a normal boy. Perfect.
I'll have to kill it again.
But you're human.
You're human now.
Yeah.
They released you. Do you want to let that thing roam free?
Wake Buffy up.
You saw it in a factory. A
Buffy will take care of it.
We'll start there. But if it can regenerate itself, how can you kill it? Well, don't you want to wake the girl? Not for the world.
Angel, you're being kind of stupid. Wake her up.
Okay, this is not good.
Oh, you really didn't wake her up.
Comes back bigger and stronger. I think we should go back and get Buffy. I know what I'm doing. This isn't your average
demon.
You're fighting here. Nearly licked you before, and now you're mortal.
Yeah, and if this is gonna work with me and Buffy, I'm gonna have to be able to do this on my own. I can't keep risking her life every time some minion of hell. Just tell me how to kill it.
Should have worked, Buffy. Really, really dumb decision. I mean, I kind of get it, but like, that's an ego thing, and like, I don't know.
And all you can do is talk about Angel. Has it even occurred to you how this whole turning human thing might affect me? Regrettably, no. Look, if you know where he is, just tell me. He told me not to tell you. Is he in trouble? Cordelia, what are we in second grade here? Tell me. Oh, you want to talk about being mature? Maybe it's time you grew up and realized that you can't have everything. You can't have Angel and save the world. And anyway, it is your fault that he went to fight that thing by himself without... What thing?
One of us that falls, ten shall rise.
Okay, good.
You hurt my boyfriend.
Eat salt.
Did you just break her back? No.
A thousand eyes. Soldiers of darkness. I need to know if he was telling the truth.
As far as such things can be told.
What happens to the Slayer when these soldiers come?
What happens to all mortal beings, albeit sooner in her case?
She'll die.
No!
You're asking to be what you were.
You want to be a vampire, I guess?
A soul. Because of the Slayer.
Oh, this is a matter of love. It does not concern us.
Yes, it does.
Is willing to sacrifice every drop of human happiness and love he's ever known for another. He is not a lower being.
There is one way, but it is not to be undertaken lightly.
We swallow this day, as though it never happened. 24 hours from the moment the demon first attacked you, we take it back.
No!
Then none of this happened. Buffy and I.
No!
But what'll stop us from doing the exact same thing?
You. You alone will carry the memory of this day. Can you carry that burden?
So he'll remember...
They always come, and they always will. But that's my problem now, not yours, remember?
No. I won't just stand by and let you fight. Maybe die alone.
Then we fight together.
Buffy, you saw what happened last night. If anything, I'm a liability to you. You take chances to protect me, and that's not just bad for you. It's bad for the people we were meant to help. How can we be together if the cost is your life? Or the lives of others?
Oh, no, 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 no. Why?
I couldn't tell you.
When?
Another minute.
Minute? No, no, it's not enough time.
We don't have a choice, it's done.
How am I supposed to go on with my life? Knowing what we had, what we could have had.
You won't. No one will know but me.
Everything
cry.
It did.
Don't cry,
don't cry.
It did. It did. I know it did. I felt your heartbeat.
Buffy.
do this to me.
It's not enough time.
So I guess we've covered it, right?
Guess we did.
And that's all there really is to say.
Yeah. That's it.
I was told that I would need tissues, and I tried very hard not to need them. How can this show give me the one thing that I wanted, which was Bangel, and then take it away from me like that? Well, that was Angel, Season 1, Episode 8. I will remember you. I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction video. I'll see you in the next one, which should be Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Season 4, Episode 9, called Something Blue. I will see you then.